Basketball season is here, and the Wright State Raiders are adjusting to life without love.
Dayton 24/7 Now's Andre Johnson at the Nutter Center tonight, showing us the changes the team plans to make this season. Andre?
Yeah, guys, you can expect a lot of changes here at the Nut House this year, but the ones that players and coaches say they're most excited for is replacing all of those cardboard cutouts of Mario, Luigi, and Baby Yoda with real, live, breathing fans.
You know, it's been fun this fall watching football games and the excitement that's back in the stands, and I know our players are looking forward to that. It'll be a little odd to go on the road and you know, face that kind of thing, but it definitely should get the juices flowing. It's one of the reasons why the guys play. It makes it exciting.
It's different whenever you score a basket or you see someone score a basket and it's just dead silent. It's like a glorified scrimmage. So it's definitely exciting to get the Nut House packed again, you know, get all the students back, family members back watching us play in person. So it'll definitely bring a different vibe to the games.
On the court, the Raiders are going to be looking to replace one of the greatest players in program history in Loudon Love. But the good news is the other four starters from last year, they're all back. And things are going to look a little different this season. Last year, you often saw Love and fellow big man Grant Basile in the front court together. Well, this year, Grant's moving up to the five, which allows the Raiders to stretch the floor in ways we haven't seen in a long time.
Definitely, it's a different team right now. We can spread the floor out. We can all shoot the ball. We can all drive. We can do a little bit of everything. The floor will definitely be more spread out. I think that creates opportunities for everybody, honestly, throughout 1 through 15. But, yeah, we're really excited just to get a new chemistry and just a new team system throughout the program.
This year we'll be able to play a little faster. We still have some other good bigs. We'll be able to play too big and kind of take advantage of that inside mismatches yet again. But I think, again, we'll be able to cause some mismatches with five wide. Tanner and Tim are such great post guys, and Trey's so quick with the basketball that we'll be able to take advantage of some mismatches if we go smaller and take advantage of some quickness.
The Raiders were voted to finish second in the Horizon League's preseason poll. Forward Grant Basile was voted to the preseason All-Conference first team, and guard Tanner Holden was voted to the second team. Now to the women of Wright State, where the word of the day is change. Most of the big contributors on that team from last year that went to the NCAA tournament and won their first game in program history, they're all gone, including head coach Katrina Merriweather and stars like Angel Baker, Tyler Frierson, and Imani Jefferson. So now, led by new head coach Kerry Hoffman, the Raiders are trying to plant the seeds to what they hope will grow into a winning program for years to come. Because with a mix of old faces and new ones, Coach Kaufman says the one thing that won't change is the standard that this team holds itself to.
This group expects to win, and that's one of the things that has impressed me the most about being here is there is a culture of winning, and I love that. I think we need to continue to work on our habits to make that happen.
And it all goes down next Tuesday. Dayton men, Dayton women, Wright State men, and Wright State women all tipping off their seasons on November 9th. And we're going to have all of that coverage for you right here on Dayton 24/7 Now. That's a look at your local sports from the Nut House. I'm going to send it back to Adam, Megan, and Natalie in the studio.